This is going to be a relatively short video on how to differentiate power series. So say I've got this power series that looks like n equals 0 to infinity, a sub n, x to the n. Okay? So that would just mean we'd have a naught x to the 0, which is 1, plus a1 x to the first, x8, or a2 x2. That looks fine. a2 x2, a3 x3, etc., 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 do-do-do, like that. Okay. Now, if I normally wanted to differentiate something, I could just look at it and I could differentiate this guy right here. I'm like, okay, well, that's going to go to 0. So it's going to be a1 plus 2a2x plus 3a3x squared. And actually, let's add a couple more terms just to make sure we're happy. a4x to the 4, a5x to the 5. So then if I keep going, I got 4a4x to the cubed. And then 5a5x to the, a5x to the fourth, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, so I can differentiate along those lines. Now, assuming that that's done, that's well and good, but what if I actually didn't want to have to write it out to differentiate it? What if I actually just want to differentiate from the summation? So if I want to differentiate from the summation, it's pretty much the same thing as differentiating in real life, which is apparently not what we're doing here, is I'm going to take the coefficient, I'm going to put it in front, and I'm going to subtract 1 off of it. Okay, so let's go ahead and put in the summation. I'm going to leave the limits off for a minute, but I'm going to pull the n out front, a sub n, x to the n, minus 1. Now, notice that I left the summation limits off. I know it's going to go n from something to infinity, and my initial instinct is going to be to put it at 0, but I'm not sure if that's right. Now, I'm going to get 0, a to the 0, x to the negative 1, and you're like, well, that's 0, and that's fine. And then I get 1, a to the 1, x to the 1 minus 1, which is 0, which is that. And then I've got 2, so 0, 1, 2. So x to the 2 minus 1, which is just 1. All right, so this is actually looking pretty good. I've got this term, the a1 term is good, the a2 term is good. There's no reason to think it's not going to stay good. The only problem is I have this weird thing going on here with a 0 and an x to the minus 1. And basically, the problem with starting at 0 is that technically maybe you can get away with it, but ultimately what's going to happen is if you have this infinite power series and you differentiate it, you're going to end up with infinity, and this sounds going to sound really stupid, but you end up with infinity minus 1 terms here. So, and I know it's not really the way math works, but if I have infinity terms for the power series, when I differentiate it, I lose a term, so I actually get infinity minus 1. And that's not like the official reason. I'm sure there's a better reason, but it's the best reason that's the most intuitive to me. So who cares if it's wrong? As long as it's, like, I mean, I don't know. Just believe me. When you become a math major and like learn stuff, you could be like, that was stupid. And then you can make your own videos and everybody will be happy. But basically the idea is whenever you differentiate, you have to increase the power or increase the thingy down here by 1. And so at this point, I can take a second derivative by pulling the coefficient down, so I have a summation, and now I'm going to start at 2. So I'm going to pull the coefficient out front, and I'm going to subtract 1 off of it again to take the derivative. So I have n minus 1 times n, a sub n, x to the n minus 2. And really, when you're differentiating, that's all you do, is just do that over and over and over and over, and as long as you remember to change your indices, then you're good to go.